A very warm welcome again. In the previous videos of this section, we have talked about several business aspects related to electric vehicles. Today is the last of this series, and we will learn about a model that has been developed to give us detailed insight in how a future with autonomous electric vehicles, smart charging, and vehicle-to-grid could look like. And importantly, it will help us prepare for such a future by rethinking city design, electricity grid developments, and transportation. What we have seen is the potential of these various innovations and how they could provide values to various actors. However, there are still many uncertainties of what the effects will be on the world we live in. This is because the technology is still immature. There has never been any large-scale implementation, and there is very limited information available on the safety and security effects on the public realm. So before decision makers can devise effective policies and implement successful plans, they will want to test the possible options. Therefore, pilot projects or living labs can be initiated. But these can be expensive and take very long. This may make you think, wouldn't there be a smarter alternative to this? Well, computers and, for example, virtual reality certainly have taken giant steps forward. So what if we benefit from this and test these innovations in virtual pilots? That would sure save us a lot of time and money. These virtual pilots, or simulations, should be close to reality. So we need a realistic model in which we can simulate a future situation in a city. Only then we can take away these uncertainties and really understand their impact. This will then allow us to test and validate strategies and policies before we implement it. What would we include in such a model? Which important parameters and developments do we need to take into account? Well, certainly a realistic model of how EVs are bought, so we can accurately estimate the uptake of EVs in an area. Furthermore, an accurate representation of how these vehicles will be used for driving and charging. What we mean here with realistic is that we really want to be as close to reality as possible. This means that we will simulate the behavior of each choice made by a car driver separately. I will come back to this later. And for decision makers to make a well-informed choice, it is important to have easily adjustable scenarios to be able to compare various strategies and policy instruments. Therefore, we have developed the Spark City model. In this model, we focus on a certain neighborhood that we can start by taking its physical layout and spatial characteristics. Then for each resident and visitor, we will model their behavior individually. These people are then called agents. We model if and when they buy a new car, how they use it to drive around, and if and when they charge their vehicle. Furthermore, we can add more layers to this model. An important one is the electricity grid. This means we include in the model how electricity cables and transformers are spread through their neighborhood and what the load is on each. We can also include future grid expansion plans. This model can very accurately simulate many developments, for example, how the growth of EVs in a certain area will take place, and how this would be different for specific EV incentive schemes. Another is to analyze the effect of different rollout policies for charging infrastructure. These could differ, for example, in the focus on on-street charging versus park-and-charge hubs at centralized parking areas. And what would be the consequence for the electricity grid? And how does this depend on the implementation of smart charging and vehicle-to-grid? To analyze and simulate a certain part of the city, we can build up a neighborhood by making use of open data. This is based on their unique characteristics. This is part of the input needed to start an analysis. If we then look at the output of the model, we could see the following. Here we see a result of the adoption of electric vehicles in three neighborhoods. Note that in one, the blue bars, the adoption rate is much higher than in the other two. To give you an even better understanding of the model capabilities, in the next slide, I will show you three example cases. In the first example, we look at a forecast of congestion in the low voltage grid due to EV charging. This way, we can see what the expected impact is of the grid and how this, for example, depends on the amount of fast chargers implemented in a certain area. We can build on this analysis and identify, quantify to what extent smart charging and vehicle-to-grid can reduce this congestion. Through such analysis, we compare the effect of different strategies. Besides different EV charging strategies, we can also dive deeper into the changing mobility patterns in a part of the city and how this can be influenced by, for example, car sharing schemes. Through this, we can see how this would reduce the need for public parking places, which would create more space for walkways, housing, or green areas. This can be used as input for a study that looks into the societal benefits of car sharing schemes for a city, now and in the future. In the last and third example, I would like to show you the possibilities of this model to combine the transition to electric vehicles and other energy innovations, such as solar panels. We can envision a neighborhood in the not-so-distant future where many of the houses are equipped with rooftop solar panels and half of the vehicles are plug-in hybrids. What would be the effect on the electricity grid? And taking into account the driving patterns of the cars, could these cars be used to store locally produced solar energy during the day and feed it back to the grid in the evening? This can be of value to the grid operator, but also to a city that wants to increase their share of locally utilized renewable electricity. For homeowners, that can also drive an EV. It can be meaningful to be able to share self-produced solar power with neighbors, thus creating stronger social cohesion and becoming more independent. This could be a glimpse into the sustainable energy future that we all want to be part of. And with that, I would like to conclude this video. I hope this has shown you the many ways that EV can be of value to a wide range of stakeholders, and that you have a better understanding of the way these cars can be used and charged in a smarter way that opens new doors instead of creating problems. Thank you very much.